Teddy Bear by A.A. Milne. Our bear, whoever had, he cries. Grows tabby without exercise. Our teddy bear is short and fat. It's not to be wondered at. He gets what exercise he can by following the automatic, but generally seems to lack the energy to clamber back. Nocturnus is just the thing which gets a fellow wondering, and Teddy worried lots about the fact that he was rather stout. He thought, if only I were thin, but how does anyone begin? He thought, it really isn't fair to grudge me exercise and air. For many weeks he pressed in vain his nose against the window pane, and envied those who walked about, reducing their unwanted stout. None of the people he could see is quiet, he said, as fat as me, and with a still more mood. I mean, he said, as fat as I. Now Teddy, as was only right, slept in the automat at night, and with him crowded in as well, more animals I can tell. Not only these, but books and things, such as the calculation brings, old tales of once upon a time, and history he told in rhyme. One night attendant took a pre-patterned old picture book, wherein he came across by chance the picture of a king of France, a stoutish man, and down below these words, King Louis, so and so, nickname the handsome. There he sat, and think of it, the man was fat. I bet he'd just like anything to read about this famous king, nicknamed the handsome, not a doubt. The man was definitely stout. Why then a bet? All his stout might get named the handsome cub, might yet be named a diddy he mean. That years ago he met had been, for now he felt a status given. Is Louis so and so still living? Fashion and beauty have a way of altering from day to day. It's handsome Louis for this year. Unfortunately, I forget. Next morning, nose to window pane. The doubt occurred to him again. One question hammered in his head. Is he alive or is he dead? Thus, nose to pane, he pondered. But the latest window was loosely shut. Soon the prince window started. Oh, and it disappeared below. There happened to be passing by a plump man with a twinkling eye, who seemed standing in the street. He was politely on his seat feet, and murmured kindly in his ear, so forth, and of cheer. Well, allow me, not at all. Tut, a very nasty fall. Our Teddy answered not a word. It's doubtful if he even heard. Our bear could only look and look at the stout man in the picture book. That handsome king could be this man of adversity. Possible, he thought, but still rather nasty. Yes, I will. Are you? He said, by any chance, his majesty, the Queen of France. The other answered, I am. Then bowed stiffly and removes his hat. Then said, excuse me, is it Mr. Edward Bear? And Teddy, bending very low, replied, politely, even so. They stood beneath the window there, the King and Mr. Edward Bear. And handsome, if I try good night, the humanity of this and that, then said his majesty, well, I must get on and ring the bell. Your bear, I think, is my good day, and don't come his way. Our bear, whoever heart he tries, to establish that societies are teddy bear is short and fat, which is not to be wondered at. But do you think it worth it to know that he is far from slim? No, just the other way about. He's proud of being short and stout. Thank you.